Now let's talk about the final derivation that you need to do. Take these two equations and substitute in the derivatives in space, the current, and the derivative in time up into this top equation, like so. And then solve this equation for the future time, which is I of n. Here, I want you to substitute all of these in and solve for v at n plus 1. And then, after you have done that, let's talk about the algorithm. We're going to have an algorithm that solves the transmission line as a function of z. The matrix that we're going to be storing is going to be the voltage and the current in each cell along this transmission line. So we're going to have a v of k, and we're going to have an I of k that tell us about the different in voltages and currents on this transmission line. Also, the RLGC parameters are all going to be functions of k. We'll put these in a time loop, so what we're going to do is first set the voltage source. Normally we have a voltage source and not a current source. Set the voltage source at some point. This is going to be my source point, and you're going to set that as a function of time. The time, remember, is n times delta t, and we're starting out at zero time. So set your voltage source and then solve for voltage every place on that transmission line. That means that you're going to have a for loop that's a function of k. Then solve for all the current terms as a function of k. That's another for loop. And finally, do this for all time. Run each of your k loops from k equals 1 to big K. Run your n loop from 1 to big N. By resetting your source each time, you'll be following through, for instance, a sinusoidal source. Let's suppose that this is V source. When n equals 0, we're right here. When n equals 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and so on. So this is how your FDTD algorithm is going to function.